Daddy, like, I can't believe you're doing this. This is my birthday. Like, this is supposed to be my night. How could you invite all those people behind my back? Like, really?
Honey, breathe. You're right. It is your birthday. One that should be spent with family, however distant they may be.
But, like, I wanted to go somewhere magical, like Paris, Rome, or, like, Disneyland.
You really don't think you can have fun in this big mansion? I've raised you in the lap of luxury, given you all you could have asked for. The one thing you can do for me is welcome your family and be happy that they are here. They're always the brightest bunch.
Sir, the weather is growing worse. Hopefully all of your guests arrive before the storm hits. I haven't seen a storm like this since Tijuana. Speaking of which, did I ever show you the scar on my buttocks?
From the peacock? Don't touch the peacock.
Or else you get your knees rocked.
Well, hello, brother of mine. Are you ready for this good time? I'm ready for this good time. This is a lot more spacious than that tent I sleep in. Smells like pine cone, my little brother.
Very good to see you, Jeffrey.
It's pronounced wacky, Uncle Jeff. I even got it on the ID. Is this fault taken?
Darling, when will the party begin?
Very soon, my dear, but we still have many guests to arrive.
Oh, well, give me a ring when they're all here.
Sir, the Boards family have arrived.
We have been doing great.
Wonderful. Richer than ever.
Where's the bathroom? I need to use the bathroom, please.
Where is the bathroom?
Down the hall, turn left again, then a right, past the knight statue, around the helicopter pad, take a right, and it should be 7 doors down, the red one.
Thank you for helping us. I won't forget it.
Woo, doggy! I didn't even know I had this many relatives. Hey, got any cheese I could eat? I need my daily cheese.
There's some in the fridge, I believe. Don't eat the cheddar, Jeffrey. That's my cheddar.
Well, that seems to be everyone. Attention, my wonderful guests. Dinner will be served in 2 hours. So breathe, refresh, relax. My butler will show you all to your rooms.
All of them.
No, child, that boy is not coming over here tonight. It is pouring outside, and this is a family night.
Like, why does it matter?
Because it's important to your father.
We can just sit in the corner and, like, loathe in each other's silence.
Absolutely not. You will sit next to your wacky Uncle Jeff and Emmett.
Really? The clown?
Yes, the clown.
No, like, you're not my father.
But I am, and you will attend this dinner in its entirety.
Okay, whatever, but I'm gonna be sad and miserable and gloomy the whole time. Like, for sure.
How do you do it? Raising a child as a single parent?
Fortitude, endurance, and money.
Captivating.
Monsieur Sacrebleu!
Yes, no, nothing.
Dinner is served in 15 minutes. The table is all set and ready. And tonight, on the menu, sautéed pork chops, delectable mashed potatoes, garlic bread, and the specialty, Kraft macaroni and cheese. A bon appetit.
Yay, yay, yay! We're out of mac and cheese! Why was there so little mac and cheese?
We ran out of cheddar cheese.
I think it's time for a toast. To my birthday, girl. Happy birthday. And to the rest of my family, I'm glad you could all witness my extreme wealth. Silverware came straight from Fiji. and to...
No! My brother!
I got you guys. You should have seen the look on your faces. What a great and well thought out prank.
He's dead.
Did you do this? Did you kill him?
Of course not, Sugar. I would never do anything to jeopardize us.
This could be bad. If they find out about our romance, they'll think we did it. We could be sent to jail. Oh God, I am too pretty for jail.
More Shari, calm down. We will get through it together.
Really?
Don't worry, Flower. They won't find out. I'll do anything I have to. Anything. Now, let's get back before people notice we're gone.
Everyone, I've contacted the police. I have some bad news, though. Due to the storm and the fact that the nearest police station is 24 kilometers away, they will not be able to get here for quite some time.
So what are you saying?
I'm saying the killer is among us. We should stay here in the room as much as possible, but groups of us could go leave for water or food, or to investigate other parts of the house for clues. You three, go look for water, the boards investigate, you three, go check the kitchen for food supplies, and that leaves us to stay here and watch out for anything suspicious. If you see or hear anything, come back here immediately. Good luck. I can't believe he's dead. After years of taking care of this family, and he's taken away just like that. I should have done more to protect him.
It's not your fault. Nobody could have expected this. You have served us so well, and you're right by his side and... The war.
The war?
Oh yes, your father and I fought in the war together.
Like what war?
The war. It was a chaotic time. I was just a young lad stationed under your father's command in Boise. The war wasn't bad at first. We hung out with the locals and painted pictures of each other on the sidewalk. But everything changed that fateful night.
What happened?
The battle.
Which battle?
The battle. I'm scared, sir.
Don't worry. We'll get through this together. I promise.
But how? We can't win.
Just take my hand, and everything will be okay.
I love you.
I know.
Hey. Hey.
What? Oh, yes, I'm fine. After the war, your father and I made an oath to stay by each other's side. He was the Leonardo DiCaprio to my Kate Winslet. I was the peanut butter to his jelly. I became his butler, and in return, he gave me a home and a family.
That is so sweet and wholesome. Like, I can't believe I didn't know this about father.
Oh, trust me, there are many things you don't know about your father, and some things you don't want to know. He's traveled the world, and he knows a lot of people. Some pretty bad people.
What happened?
We were grabbing food from the kitchen when the lights went out and I heard footsteps. Next thing you know, Johnny has a knife in his back.
We heard screaming and came as quickly as we could.
Is everything okay?
Johnny's dead.
Did any of you split off from the group?
Nope. Well, I tried to. For some reason, these two kept running away from me. Oh, wait. I get it.
That means the only two who could have done it is the chef or the maid.
No way the maid could have done it. I've worked with her for years. I mean, look at the poor woman. She's out cold.
This looks bad. Yes. But this was our setup. I have an alibi. Me and the maid were looking for dairy products since those expire the fastest. And she will tell you the same when she wakes up.
D-
Did you find anything?
Not much. Just cheese.
What kind?
Parmesan.
Did you see that?
Hi everyone. Sorry I'm late. What did I miss?
Who are you? And how did you make it through the storm? Not even the police could make it through that rain.
Jackie Wildebeest, and I got here by my heat-powered oxygen air basket.
Oh, I've heard about you. You're Jackie?
Wait, like, don't you mean hot air balloon?
No, heat oxygen air basket. I travel the world exploring and learning about creatures and beasts.
What kind of beasts?
All of them. I received an invitation to this party from a dear friend of mine. Where is my buddy, by the way?
He's dead.
Oh, I'm sorry. He was a nobleman.
Wait just one second, Art! How do we not know that this is not the killer?
Killer? He was killed? I may have a pretty good shot, but I would never do that to an old friend. We travel the world together, seeing amazing places and discovering the deepest parts of our soul.
Oh, jeez.
I'm going to help you solve this mystery. With my extreme intellect and knack for survival, I bet I could solve this pretty quickly.
Hey now, before we start investigating again, I'm dying for a good glass of water. We didn't find much last time we went exploring.
Ah, like, my stomach hurts.
Perfect. You nice-looking people, stay here and watch out for the bad guys. All the rest of us, go get them goodies. I trust you. Ladies and gentlemen, keep your arms and legs inside the vehicle at all times.
Johnny was quite an easy one. Who should we get next?
I want them all dead. How should we do it? Poison? Or maybe some piranhas? I love dangerous fish.
When they come back with the food and water, we'll poison the clown's drink. Quick and easy.
They're coming back.
Turns out the supplies were in the next room over.
Well, who was supposed to check there? Oh, shoot. My bad. Oopsie-daisy.
Now that we have food and water, let's relax and eat. I get first class.
I miss my boyfriend. Like, if he was here, I'd feel so much better.
Don't mean to intrude, but tell me about this boy.
Well, he's really sweet. He likes to buy me cute little gifts, even though I can buy whatever I want. And he's so kind. He takes in these poor little injured birds and he helps them heal. And then he sends them back out into the wild. Can you believe it?
A boy that likes animals. He's lovely.
He is. But my father's woman hates him. And they've never even spent any time with him.
There's one thing I've learned from watching the sunrise on the African savannah. Is that life is unfair. But when life hits you down, what do you have to do? You uppercut it right back. The only thing that could stop a charging rhino is love. Love is what gives humans their flaws and perfections. It pushes us to the limits beyond what is possible. Love is the foundation of our society, and love is the force that drives people to get out of bed, put on a smile, and take on the world.
Wow, like you are so wise.
Nah, life teaches you a few things at my age, but I still have lots to learn. Your father and I experienced a lot together.
So you're an old friend of his?
Yes, we've kept in touch. But time makes people drift apart. He writes a letter to me every year on my birthday, and I send back something I found in the wilderness. We have a bond as strong as a lion's roar. He would have loved that one.
You seem very close to him, but I think I knew him a bit better. You see, for we struggled through the bloodshed of war together, and came out the other side stronger and closer. He told me everything. I even knew his sleep schedule, and I've never even heard of you.
Well, he tells me everything, and I've never heard about you.
I just put the poison in the clown's drink. He should be going to the bathroom any time now, and he won't come back.
Who's next, Mommy?
I think that extremely wacky Uncle Jeff should be next in line.
Man, I'm having a good time!
Honey, I can't take much more of this.
What do you mean?
All of these murders and being stuck in here with these people, I can't take it anymore. I'm sorry, but I can't be with you.
Moshari, why?
It's all just too much. I thought I loved you, but when he got shot, I realized I never loved you how I loved him.
But...
What about Duck Duck Goose?
My leg hurts, and I don't want to run around.
Ooh, Twister?
How do you expect my old behind to get anywhere near that floor?
It's all about stretching, baby.
Everyone, there has been another tragedy. It's Emmett. He's dead.
What happened? Where'd you find him?
I was just looking for clues, and I went to take a tinker. Then I walked in and saw the clown lying by the toilet. I thought he was sleeping or something, but I looked closer, and he was dead.
Well, is he still there?
Yes, I ran straight back here.
Well, we need to go investigate the body. What a shame. The final resting place of a porcelain toilet.
Well, should we all go? You can't go alone.
Sadly, that is the oldest bathroom in the house, and we can't all fit in there.
Didgeridoo day. I guess I'll go alone. I'm used to it. Unless you count on the camera crew. But they kind of just stand around or whatever, so it's fine.
Not with a killer amidst us. No one goes alone. I shall come with you.
Huh? Thanks. Okay, everyone. You should all stay here.
None of this would have happened if my dad didn't set up this stupid dinner party, invite my stupid relatives, and, like, ruin my stupid birthday.
I'm sorry.
No. It's not your fault. It's not his either. He just wanted to spend time with family. And, like, he was getting pretty old. And he always talked about you guys. I should have listened to him.
He was always so kind to us.
To him, we were all family.
Oh, no, 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 no. A lightning bolt has hit the house and my kitchen is on fire. Everyone help. Quick, grab buckets, towels, and fire extinguishers. Go, go, go!
Where'd everybody go? I don't smell that bad. Do I?
What a fool.
Sad. Really.
Oh good, you guys are here. Where'd everybody go?
You really are an idiot. Just like all the morons in this house.
I know. I might be a little different, but I'm not stupid. Why do you guys have to be so mean to me? Wait, what are you holding behind your back?
Oh, nothing. Just a knife.
What's going on here? My God, are you the killers? But you were such kind and polite people. You just were silent and watched us and... Oh, right, that makes sense.
How could you? We trusted you. He trusted you. How could you do something so sinister?
Oh my Lord, this is crazy. Even for me.
Well, it's time to end this mockery and finish what we started.
It's the murderers! Get them!
Take them away. Put them in the kitchen till the cops get here.
It actually caught on fire when you guys all left.
It's nearly all gone.
Is that what that sound was? My God. I just thought the fireplace was on a high setting. Put them in the laundry room or something.
Wow, you did some great work out there.
Thanks, mate. You weren't too bad yourself. Maybe we're not so different, you and I.
Maybe not. Great work, everyone. Only 3 people died today.
This is the cops. We just want to make sure the murderers are locked in before we get there. Hitting some unlucky red lights. Ha ha ha.
Yes.
just in that room.
They've escaped. Run!